Hi, I'm Chris with Resideo, and I'm here to share with you a few tech tips to help when using Universal RTS products. Today's tech tip will focus on the S9200 Universal Integrated Furnace Control. One of the most common obstacles technicians encounter is their apprehension when installing the S9200 compared to the OEM like-for-like board. I will show you the process of how to cross-reference the S9200 to your application, select the right harnesses, and select the dip switch settings. In the box, you're going to find the board, of course, our installation manual, let's not forget about these, our equipment wiring adapters, and a couple mounting screws. To begin, we have to look up our board. Here we will open up our instructions and we will find the cross-reference list. We'll locate the SKU of our equipment and then the harness adapters for that piece of equipment, and that's where we will also find our settings for dip switch 1 and dip switch 2. So let's cross-reference 1 as an example. Let's look at replacing a United Technology board 1012-933D. As you can see, the part number on the board uses a dash, but in our instructions, it is listed without. For this application, we will be using harness E for the main connector and harness F for the inducer and HSI connector. So we will take all the harnesses out of the bag, locate E and F, and the remaining harnesses are no longer needed. You're now ready to mount your board. Let's remove the old board from the mounting surface with the wire still attached if possible before mounting the new board. If that isn't possible, label the wires before you remove them or transfer them to the matching terminals on the S9200 as you pull them from the old board. I would also recommend taking a picture of where the wires are located on the board before pulling them off. So at this time, let's attach our adapter harnesses to the board. Oh, it only goes on one way and snaps in place. And then the second harness for the inducer motor, oh, that only goes on one way and snaps in place. So now let's take a look at our dip switch settings. We will begin with S1, which is the four position switch block. In our instructions for our board, SW1 is on, SW2 is off, SW3 is on, and SW4 is listed as off. So we will go right here and adjust the dip switches accordingly. They will all be in the off position, new from the factory, and we will only have to move the dip switches into the on position as needed. So now let's take a look at our second dip switch block, S2, which is our two position switch block. In our instruction manual, it shows under S2 that SW1 is off and SW2 is in the on position. So when we go to our board, you will see that SW1 is off from the factory along with SW2. So the only one we need to move is SW2 into the on position. That's all I have for you today. Remember, our tech support team is here to help at 1-800-468-1502. Thank you for watching.